It is like a army of the body.
Yes.
Isn't it? Army of the body. So it has to fight against the foreign bodies. Okay. Foreign bodies. Fight against the foreign bodies. That is why in the oral cavity. Here the palatine tonsil are there, lingual tonsil. Okay. And the adenoids in the form of ring, lymphatic tissue is there. Okay, at the oral cavity. So this is a main entry to the body, isn't it? So it may contain the bacteria, virus, this, that, to fight against that, there are the police ones. They are shooting, isn't it? Think like that. Okay. This is about the lymphoid organ. So the what is the function of lymph node?
It
filters the lymph, is that it? It filters the lymph. So, it is an alternate channel or alternate system to the venous system. So, same thing in the venous capillaries are there. Same thing, alternate to venous capillary, there are capillary which are nothing but the venous capillaries or venous system. So, it is alternate to the venous system, isn't it? Lymphatic system. So first one is the spleen. About the spleen, the location of the spleen, we have to divide the abdomen into 9 quadrants, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you want to study any organ in the abdomen, so which reason it comes? You have to tell, isn't it? So that's why we divided abdomen into the 9 quadrants.
Yes.
So the these perpendicular line, these are nothing but midclavicular line on either side. Clavicle is there, isn't it? Midpoint of clavicle, draw a line. Midclavicular line, and here at the 9th costal cartilage, okay, and the trans-tubercular lining, this one. Anterior, superior, iliac spine is there. Tubercle, isn't it? Through that, left and right, you have to draw the line. So, this divides the abdominal cavity into 9 quadrants. Left hypochondrium, right hypochondrium, epigastric, right lumbar, umbilical region, left iliac region, hypogastric region, and the right iliac region. Okay. Here the cecum, where it is present?
Hypogastric.
Here it is the cecum, isn't it?
Cecum.
Beginning part of the colon, isn't it? Where it is present? Right iliac fossa, isn't it? Right iliac fossa. So the spleen, it is located in the left hypochondric region and partly the epigastric region. Okay, about the location. So about the introduction of the spleen, it is a soft, highly vascular and dark purple in color. Okay, where it is located? It is located in the
left
hypochondric region
and epigastric,
and partly in the epigastric. This is about the location of the spleen. Okay, and it is related to the 9th and 11th rib. Between the 9th and 11th rib in the left hypochondrium. Next is about the measurements of the spleen. So odd numbers from 1 to 11. 1 inch thick, 3 inch broad, 5 inch long, okay, and 7 ounce in weight. That is roughly 200 grams, isn't it? And between the 9th and 11th rib. So, from 1 to 11, odd numbers, isn't it? Okay. This is about the measurements. Next is the features of the spleen. It has two ends, anterior and posterior end. And the anterior end, it is expanded, directed downwards and forwards. Okay. So it is having anterior end and the posterior end. Anterior end and the posterior. Anterior end and the posterior end. And the posterior end, it is rounded, directed upwards, backwards and median. Posterior end. And next is the three borders. The superior border, okay, and not near the anterior end. And the inferior border, rounded, and the intermediate border, it is also rounded, isn't it? So these are the borders of the spleen: superior border, inferior border, and the intermediate border. Three borders. And next is the which has got two surfaces: the diaphragmatic surface and the visceral surface. See here, it is the thoracic cavity and the abdominal cavity, isn't it? So partition, it is by the diaphragm muscle here, isn't it? Here it is the spleen. So the diaphragmatic surface, it is related to the diaphragm, okay. And the inner layer, that is the visceral surface, visceral surface and the diaphragmatic surface. So the diaphragmatic surface, it is smooth and convex, smooth and convex, whereas the visceral surface, it is irregular, isn't it? And bears a many impression. So here is the plastinated model of the spleen, okay. So it is present like this, isn't it? Like this anatomical position. So the superior border, okay, which are bears a notches here, isn't it? Notch, superior border, inferior border and the intermediate border, okay. And here it is the diaphragmatic surface and the visceral surface. Diaphragmatic, how it is? It is a smooth, isn't it? Diaphragmatic surface. And visceral surface, it is irregular and bears some impression, isn't it? Some impression, irregular. And anterior end, posterior end, superior border, inferior border, intermediate border, diaphragmatic surface and the visceral surface. These are the presenting parts of the spleen, okay. And next is about the visceral surface. It is having gastric impression. Fundus of the stomach is related to this. See here, here it is the gastric surface. Superior border, gastric surface, isn't it? So it is related to the fundus part of the stomach. Lies between the superior and intermediate border. So it lies between the superior border and the intermediate border, isn't it? And next is the renal impression. So here it is between the intermediate border and the inferior border. Renal impression, gastric impression, isn't it? And it is related to the left kidney. So it is present in the left side, isn't it? So this is related to left kidney, and it lies between the intermediate and the inferior border. And next is the pancreatic impression. It lies between the hilum of the spleen and the colic impression. So here it is the colic impression, the renal impression and the gastric impression. So in between, so this is a hilum, hilum of the spleen. So between the hilum and the colic impression, there is a pancreatic impression here. Okay. Pancreatic impression, tail of the pancreas is related to this part. that diagram it is very clear, isn't it? Pancreatic depression, isn't it? Gastric depression.
Renal.
And the colic impression. Okay. So the pancreatic impression, where it is present? Between the hilum and the colic impression. Here it is the pancreatic impression, isn't it? So superior border, inferior border, and the intermediate. Clear now?
Yes.
Next is the hilum, the inferomedial part of the gastric impression. Inferomedial part of the gastric impression, there is a hilum of the spleen, okay, through which splenic vessels and nerve passes. Isn't it? Through which splenic vessels and nerve passes. Hilum, it is the main door of this, isn't it? Okay. And transmits splenic vessels and the nerves, and this hilum provides the attachment to the gastrosplenic and linorenal ligament. Okay, so here two ligaments are attached. The gastrosplenic, name itself is indicated, isn't it? From stomach to the spleen. Okay, there is a ligament which contains the short gastric artery, that ligament. Okay. Between these two, between the greater part, greater curvature of the stomach and the spleen, which contains the short gastric artery.
Okay.
Enter the hilum. So just the content. Yeah. Just it is a ligament, within that there are short gastric artery. Short gastric means which supplies the stomach, isn't it? Short gastric supplies the stomach.
So it is between those two ligaments?
Yes. And linorenal ligament. Linorenal, name itself is indicated. Linorenal. Lino means the spleen and the kidney, isn't it? Anterior surface of the kidney. Between these two, there is a ligament. Okay. That is nothing but a sheath, isn't it? Which contains the tail of pancreas, splenic vessels and nerve. Okay. Splenic vessels and nerve and the tail of pancreas in the linorenal ligament. Next is about the arterial supply. It is by the splenic artery. Branch from the aorta. It is a branch of the celiac trunk, isn't it? Splenic artery. And the venous drainage, it is by the splenic vein, isn't it?
Celiac.
And nerve supply, it is by the celiac plexus. So the sympathetic fibers from the celiac plexus supplies the capsule of the spleen, okay, which is vasomotor to the muscle fibers present in the capsule of the spleen. Okay, so the nerve supply, it is by the celiac plexus, isn't it? And about the splenic vein, I think you might have studied the portal system.
No, not yet.
Not yet. Portal circulation, portal system. So the splenic vein join with the superior mesenteric vein to form a portal vein. Splenic vein, superior mesenteric vein join to form a portal vein, which is ends in the liver, isn't it? Portal system, almost system. So forget about that. Only keep in mind venous drainage, it is by the splenic vein. Okay. And nerve supply, it is by the celiac plexus. Next is about the functions of spleen. Already I think it is taught in the histology classes, isn't it?
Yes.
The phagocytosis, hemophysis, immune responses, and the
skin. Skin.
Histologically, what people will you see? Microscopic structure of spleen. Already it is over or not?
No.
Histology.
Of spleen? No.
Yes.
No.
The thing is over.
Today.
Today it is. Okay. So yes. There is a white bulb, red bulb.
Yes.
There are lymphocytes within that, isn't it? Microscopically. Yes. This is about the spleen. Okay. Presenting parts. So anterior end, posterior end.
Intermediate.
Three borders, two surfaces. Isn't it? And about the arterial supply, venous drainage, and the nerve supply. Okay. And especially in the visceral surface, there are impression. Go through that. So the gastric impression,
renal
impression, colic
impression,
pancreatic impression. So this is a lab. So the questions may come from this lab or hospital. Okay, for hospital. So next is about the lymphatic drainage of the lower limb. It is divided into superficial group and the deep group. So in the superficial group, there is a T-shaped group of lymph nodes just below the inguinal ligament. Okay. So here is the inguinal ligament, isn't it? So here the horizontal group of lymph nodes, okay, lateral to the below and lateral to the inguinal ligament. So medial to below and medial to the inguinal ligament, there is a vertical group of lymph nodes here. These are the superficial group of lymph nodes which drains the skin and superficial fascia of the lower limb and also skin of, from the just below the umbilicus and the buttock region. All the lymphatic drainage drains into the superficial group of lymph node. Okay. Superficial inguinal group of lymph node. Okay. So these are arranged in horizontal and vertical group in T shape. Isn't it? In T shape, these lymph nodes are arranged here, superficial. So the drainage area, the superficial tissue, everything superficial to the deep fascia. Okay. Superficial to the deep fascia, that part. Okay, from lower limb, except the posterolateral part of the leg, posterolateral part of the leg, that part except whole of lower limb, it drains into the superficial group of lymph node. Okay, and that is drains into the popliteal group of lymph nodes. So those are the deep group of lymph node, popliteal group. Okay. See here, these are popliteal group of lymph nodes, deep one. These are the superficial one. So the posterolateral part of the leg or calf drains into the popliteal group of lymph node. So ultimately popliteal group of lymph node drains into the deep inguinal group of lymph node. Okay, deep inguinal group of lymph node. This is about the superficial inguinal lymph node. Why? What's the matter? Is it bouncing? Is it bouncing? Why you are laughing?
Bouncing.
You people are understanding or not?
Yeah. I'm with you.
Then why you are laughing?
Just asking him about the lymph node.
Yes, in the inguinal group of lymph node, I told you, it is divided into superficial and deep, isn't it? Superficial T-shape. And deep group, it is nothing but the popliteal group of lymph node and the deep inguinal group of lymph node, where the femoral vein is present. I'll show you in the next picture. So deep inguinal group of lymph nodes, there are 3 or 4 in number. So here the inguinal ligament and the femoral vein, great siphonous vein draining into the femoral vein here, great siphonous vein.
Okay.
Here there are 3 to 4 in number, the lymph nodes.
Okay.
So these are the deep inguinal lymph nodes.
Okay.
So the popliteal group of lymph nodes drains into this deep inguinal group of lymph nodes, whereas the superficial group inguinal lymph nodes draining area whole of lower limb from deep fascia, superficial fascia and the skin, from deep fascia to the skin, whatever the part is there, that part the lymph drains into the superficial inguinal group of lymph node, whereas below the deep fascia, okay, below the deep fascia, that area it is drained into the deep lymph nodes, that is the popliteal group of lymph node and the deep inguinal group of lymph node. Is it clear now?
Yes, yes.
Okay. And also the perineum, skin, whole of the skin, below the umbilicus, perineum and the lower limb, all drains into the superficial inguinal group of lymph node. Below the umbilicus, perineum and the lower limb, okay, drains into the superficial group of lymph node. And ultimately what happens, the superficial group of lymph node, they crosses the lymphatic vessels, crosses the fibrae from fascia.
Okay,
so this is a fibrae from fascia
again,
and superficial group of lymph node again drains into the deep inguinal group of lymph node, ultimately drains into the deep inguinal lymph node. So the deep inguinal lymph node drains into the external iliac group of lymph node. And lymphatic drainage of the pelvis, same thing, the external iliac lymph node here, is that okay? External iliac artery. So this is a abdominal aorta. Okay. Abdominal aorta divides into common iliac, left and right, common iliac again divides into external iliac and the internal iliac. So here the internal, in the internal iliac artery, it is there, no? So there the presence of the lymph nodes, those are the internal iliac group of lymph nodes. So the, in the pelvic cavity, whatever the organs are there,
okay,
all the drains into the internal iliac group of lymph node, including the sacral group of lymph node.
Okay. See here,
the sacral group of lymph node, internal iliac group of lymph node. Okay. Ultimately, the external group of external iliac group of lymph node, internal iliac group of lymph node, ultimately drains into the common iliac nodes.
Okay.
Common iliac nodes ultimately drains into the para-aortic group of lymph nodes. Para-aortic group of lymph nodes. It is the summary about the external iliac lymph node, internal iliac lymph node and sacral group of lymph nodes, ultimately drains into the common iliac lymph nodes, isn't it?
Yeah.
Next is connection with the abdomen. So the, so here it is the anterior part of the thoracic cavity and posterior wall and the anterior wall. Here it is the sternum, isn't it? So the anterior group of lymph nodes and the lymph nodes present at the diaphragm. So these are drains into the abdominal cavity. That is why the lymphatic spread from the breast cancer to the abdominal cavity, isn't it?
Yes.
So lymph nodes present in the anterior wall of the thoracic.
Okay.
Next is the lymph node group in the abdomen. as I told you, these are divided into pre-aortic and the para-aortic. Name itself it is indicated, pre-aortic, anterior to the aorta.
Yes.
Para-aortic means on either side of the aorta. Is it clear? And this is a aorta, okay, abdominal aorta and inferior vena cava, isn't it? So here white in color, these are the pre-aortic group of lymph nodes. So the celiac group of lymph nodes, superior mesenteric group of lymph nodes and the inferior group of lymph nodes, okay, pre-aortic. And the para-aortic on either side of the aorta, the these are the para-aortic group of lymph nodes. So the whatever from the common iliac group of lymph nodes are drains into the para-aortic group of lymph node here, okay. And the inferior mesenteric and the superior mesenteric lymph draining from the small intestine and the large intestine. From the small and the large intestine, the lymph drains and ultimately drains into the superior and inferior mesenteric, then the celiac. Okay. And next is about the celiac group of lymph nodes. Here it is the celiac trunk, stomach, lesser curvature, greater curvature, and the spleen here.
Okay.
And here splenic lymph node, and here it is the gastro epiploic group of lymph node, pyloric lymph node,
okay.
And here it is the celiac group of lymph node here,
okay.
And left gastric group of lymph node, all these are drains into the celiac group of lymph node,
okay,
around the stomach,
okay.
So this is about the superior and inferior mesenteric lymph nodes.
Mm-hmm.
As I told you, it drains, lymph drains from the intestine, mainly the small and large intestine. Okay. Ultimately drains into the superior and the inferior mesenteric group of lymph node.
Yes.
Okay. And para-aortic group of lymph nodes, draining area, that is lower limb. Para-aortic group of lymph node, the draining area is the lower limb and below the umbilicus. Okay. These lymph nodes ultimately drains into the para-aortic group of lymph node. So here it is the chart. So this is an aorta, isn't it? Para-aortic group of lymph node on either side. Okay. Pre-aortic group of lymph node ventral to the aorta. There are three: celiac, superior mesenteric and the inferior mesenteric group of lymph node. So here on either side, para-aortic group of lymph node.
Mm-hmm.
So draining area, that is from the external iliac and the internal iliac group of lymph node. So the internal iliac group of lymph node drains from the pelvic cavity, isn't it? Whereas external iliac group of lymph node
lower limb,
draining from the lower limb. Okay, lower limb and also from the part below the umbilicus. All lymph drains into the external iliac. So external iliac, internal iliac drains into the common iliac group of lymph node. Then again from common iliac group of lymph node, that drains into the para-aortic group of lymph nodes on either side, left and right, isn't it? And about these are drained, what are those areas? Mainly the intestine, isn't it? Small and large intestine drains into this. Ultimately, all this group of lymph nodes are drains into the cisterna cavae. Okay,
beginning.
Cisterna cavae. What is cisterna cavae?
Beginning of
thoracic. Beginning of the
thoracic.
Thoracic duct. Very good. Beginning of the thoracic duct. You know which region? Lumbar region. At the level of L2.
Okay. Second level.
Yeah. L2. Yes. L2, the sac-like structure. Okay. Ultimately, all lymph drains into that. Okay. How many large lymph vessels are there? Large lymph?
Two. Thoracic and right thoracic.
Right
lymphatic duct and thoracic.
Right lymphatic duct and the
thoracic.
Left lymphatic duct. Left is nothing but thoracic duct, isn't it? So here my picture is there. this area, right upper limb and right part of the thoracic cavity and the right part of the head and neck. It is drained by the right lymphatic vessel and remaining part it is drained by the thoracic duct, isn't it? So here it is the thoracic cavity, isn't it? And the abdominal cavity. Here the diaphragm, isn't it? So at the lumbar region it begins cisterna cavae, isn't it? Ultimately drains into the left subclavian vein here, isn't it? And here the right lymphatic duct, it drains into the right subclavian vein. Okay. After purifying the lymph, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. This is about the lab.
Thank you so much, doctor.
And about the summary, go through the external feature of the spleen. Two ends, three borders and two surfaces. Okay. Two surfaces means outer one, diaphragmatic surface, it is a smooth, and visceral surface, it is rough, isn't it? And it is having a impression. Okay. So the gastric impression, superior border, inferior border, intermediate border, gastric impression. Okay, between intermediate border and the inferior border, there is a renal impression. Okay. And here it is the colic impression. The splenic flexure is related to this. Okay, splenic flexure of the colon. So the large intestine, it comes like this and it is having a splenic flexure. Okay, colon, it is related to this. Between the hilum and the colic flexure, there is a pancreatic impression here. Okay, and this is a gastric impression. Fundus of the stomach is located, isn't it? It is related to here. And it is having glenorenal ligament and the gastrosplenic ligament. Gastrosplenic ligament, it is nothing but the ligament between the stomach and the spleen, isn't it? Which contains the short gastric arteries. Whereas glenorenal ligament between the anterior surface of the left kidney and the spleen. So what are the contents of this ligament? Glenorenal, the tail of pancreas, splenic vessels. Okay, so these are the contents of glenorenal ligament, isn't it? This is about the ligament and presenting part and the impression. Go through this. Okay, we will ask regarding this. Okay, in the OSPI exam. Is it clear now?
Yeah, it's very clear. Thank you so much.